Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam. My name is Jacob, and today we're going to be talking about max feature that nobody uses. Max feature that you see at least 10 times a day and you never click on it. I'm talking about reference cloning. You know when you clone an object, you get that little pop-up that says copy, instance, and reference? I'm talking about that. Now, before we dive into the whole reference sphere and its importance, there's some super cool news for the RenderRam channel. So RenderRam channel, for the first time ever, has a sponsor, and sponsor is Evermotion. So the guys from Evermotion, they watched my videos, they liked the content so much that they offered their whole library of models, scenes, and everything to me to use in my videos. And what better way to celebrate that than with their party collection pack of cocktails? Look at these look so cool. Anywho, but before we get drunk on these, let's talk about reference and then we're gonna get back to these cocktails. So, let's say, for example, you have a shelf. This is a wooden shelf. You need to clone it. You clone it as an instance and you usually, let's say, clone it two times. What does instance do? Whenever you select edges, it's gonna apply to everything else. But, look at this. If you clone it as a reference, and you clone it also, let's say, two times. Here, you can notice something different. We have our editable poly, but we also have this blue bar here. Now, we're gonna get to the blue bar in a second. If I click on this editable poly, and I wanna edit the editable poly, all of them behave like standard instances. But if you click on the blue bar, and let's say you add a UVV map here, you can notice that something is wrong. Well, if I move it, that UVV map is not shown here. What does that mean? Well, basically, when you clone an object as a reference, you get that blue bar. All the modifiers below the blue bar are your original instance. But all the modifiers above the blue bar are your unique modifiers. So in this case, when you want to tweak the UVVs of these shelves, you don't need to break your instances anymore. You can just add these UV maps and they're going to behave like this. Now, there is one trick to it. The first object where we started the whole cloning thing is this. This object doesn't have this blue bar, but what you can do, right click here, make reference. Now, all three of them are references of each other and all of them function as instances, but you can do different things on top of each object and it will not break the instance. Now, let's get funky. So let's select this cocktail, for example. If you, by the way, create instance, so let's say I have 5 instances here. You didn't create any references. You can always click on an instance, right click here, and make it a reference. So you will never break your instance, but you can freely add your modifiers on top and it will just behave like this and it will still be the instance of everything else. So whenever you, for example, you go here and okay, it kind of looks crooked, and when you just lower it down, you can see that nothing changes. This is still an instance. The only thing that you need to watch out when making these references and everything, if you clone a reference and you clone it as a reference, you're gonna get a double blue line here. And of course, if you add anything to it, it's gonna behave like that. But the reference below is the one that's referencing this object here. So, like this. Also, the same thing, if you clone the reference as an instance, then you're literally created 2 instances of these objects and they are also gonna react the same. So there is a little bit of logical approach to it, but once you get the hang of it, it's goddamn amazing. I hope that you kind of understand the potential of the reference and its importance. It is literally an instance 2.0. It is an instance that you can adjust on the fly without breaking the instance. Just imagine that you have, for example, I don't know, a fence, and that fence has those poles, and you just clone it 200 times as an instance, and one of these just needs a change. Well, you're gonna break the instance, and then if you're gonna need to change something on this, you have to apply the change to these instances that you broke, or, you know, unique objects. Well, you can just right-click on that editable poly, make instance, and this will happen. Now, if you, for example, need to add something to your instance, you can come here, just add editable poly, put, I don't know, noise to it. It will all be translated because this is all one instance still, but only the things above the blue line count. So if you go here and here, for example, you want to put FFD, you can just do that, do this. If you need, for example, this object to have some specific effects, and this object is also an instance, you can just right click, make reference, and you can just do your thing. You can put a symmetry on it, and that's it. You never broke the instances. These are all the instances, and this is the magic of reference. I have no idea why this is called reference. It should be called instance. I mean, instance should be this in the first place, but for some reason it's not. So yeah, please use references. Thank you for watching. Thank you Evermotion for supplying these awesome cool models. I'm gonna leave the links to these super awesome cocktails in the description so that you can have a drink on your own. See you in the next video. Bye.